According to the National Archives, some of the documents that Donald Trump was hiding down at Mar-a-Lago may have actually been classified intelligence that Donald Trump obviously would not have been allowed to have taken from the White House, and of course stored it improperly, just sitting there in boxes for anybody who stumbles across them to go through and read this classified intelligence for the United States of America. Now that's the headline, right? That's the thing everybody's starting to get angry about, because yes, that is damaging. Yes, it's exceptionally horrible for the United States. But to me, the bigger part of this story, as reported by the New York Times, is this part. The discovery, which occurred after Mr. Trump returned 15 boxes of documents to the government last month, prompted the National Archives to reach out to the Justice Department for guidance. The department told the National Archives to have its Inspector General examine the matter. Now do you see why I'm getting so pissed off at Merrick Garland and the Department of Justice? The National Archives, and this is just one tiny little paragraph, right? And everybody's overlooking this part. The National Archives called the U.S. Department of Justice, as they're supposed to, and said, hey, we found these illegally stored and retained documents in Mar-a-Lago. You're the chief law enforcement agency in the United States. What do we do? Hey, have your guy just look at it and get back to us on that. Thanks. Click. The Department of Justice is useless. Merrick Garland is useless. This is obscene at this point. There's no other way to slice this. This is a very clear violation of the Presidential Records Act, a federal law that actually has written out penalties in the law itself, including up to 3 years in prison and being barred from ever holding office in the United States again. And the DOJ was just like, nah, why don't you just have your guy look at it and then tell us what he got? There's no need to have an inspector general look at this because we already know the boxes were there and we know the boxes weren't supposed to be there. Okay, we have the smoking gun. The smoking gun was found on the property at Mar-a-Lago. We don't need to look into it and say, well, let's just see if it is in fact a smoking gun. Maybe it's just a regular gun. We have it. We know it. We know it's a violation of the law. That's where the DOJ steps in. I don't know what the inspector general is going to find other than what's already been reported, because I don't know that anything else matters. Here's the violation of the law. You're in charge of enforcing it and investigating and prosecuting it. So you do your job now, DOJ. But again, this signals to me that the DOJ doesn't care, that the DOJ doesn't want to wade into it. And listen to what the New York Times said about that. Making a referral to the Justice Department would put senior officials in the position of having to decide whether to open an investigation, a scenario that would thrust the department into a highly contentious political matter. Oh, that's so sad for them. How horrible that the DOJ may have to do their job, even if it pisses off some of the MAGA idiots in this country. There was a very clear violation of the law here. The only question is, who did it? Did Trump not know the documents were there? Did some, you know, junior staffer decide to box them up and say, yeah, just put those on the moving truck. They're going down to Florida. That's the only question that remains to be answered. And I'm pretty sure we all can already guess what the answer to that question is. But the DOJ doesn't want to wade into it because, God forbid, they piss off the people who support this man that clearly has violated the law here. This is Hattie. Hattie wants to know why you have not subscribed to our channel. You obviously like our videos, so do us a favor and subscribe.